everybody, I'm Zedaf and Dizzy, and this is the Create mod where Redstone has had an upgrade with all things rotational and geary, as you can see, and I'm about to be sick. Oh, yeah, sorry about that. Unintentional. But what is this series going to be all about? Well, it's about the Create mod. We're not going to be doing too much survival. I have done plenty of that off camera, as you can see. We have a lot going on already. We got wheat. We got holes with animals in. We got chickens all cooped up in a thing. All kinds of plants growing. Everything a growing Zedaf needs in the world. And you can see we've also got some contraptions built as well, and that is going to be our main focus of this series. We're going to be trying to make some awesome contraptions because we can do these amazing multi-block structures. Imagine flying machines times 10, basically. You can do so much more, as well as you can do this amazing automation. Over here, I've got like an auto-cooking thing. Things go on these conveyor belts like this, and they get cooked, including me. We also have this absolutely terrifying-looking thing called a crushing wheel, or rather two crushing wheels, which pretty much lets us quadruple our ores. So if we chuck a bunch of ores here, like iron, zinc, and copper, that's right, we got a whole bunch. They get filtered down through there and plopped into this chest. Then I'm gonna get set on fire again. Okay, this place is very dangerous. Let's put ourselves out with water. Those then get turned into crushed ores, which will very, very soon, if we look, have them come out of here. There we go. One at a time. We've set a little filter on there. These things then get washed by these fans blowing through the water, and that's how all of these work. Fans blowing through hot stuff and cold stuff. And you'll see these get turned into nuggets, which is way more nuggets. How many is that? So we're going to go from 8 to 20. That was 12 nuggets from one ore. So you see, we get like a little bit extra than what we would have already had. And I also think we get multiple crushings per ore as well. So I think it's about a 4x multiplier to all of our ores, but they are in nugget form. So we got to manually go and craft up all our nugs. This thing gets very, very full of nuggets very, very quickly. But you can see I've already got a bunch of materials ready to go. I am raring and ready to get working on our first contraption. And of course, I mustn't forget to mention that my wonderful friend Tango is playing in this world with me. We're going to be next door neighbors. We're going to be contraption buddies. We're going to probably do some little collaborations together down the line. But yeah, go check him out too. He's got a parallel series with this. They will go very much hand in hand. But you can see here, I have already got the beginnings of a glorious steampunk base. This is designed by my wonderful girlfriend, dot dot dash. It is the bottom half of a windmill. It is going to be having a top half eventually as well. There's a chicken under there. But we only have the base part now, and it's also got water damage in it too. Okay, this is terrible. Very, very cool new blocks as well in this mod pack. Very nice. If we take a little look at the menu here, you can see all the different components. We've got like pipes and item transportation stuff. We've got all like block moving things. We've got new redstone stuff as well. New ores, new items, new glass. All the new decorative stuff. It is crazy. We have liquid chocolate too. So yeah, you know you're going to have a good time if liquid chocolate's involved. Now we are going to be shortly getting onto today's main project, but first, I need to make these cogs spin. I can't have static things in this world. And to achieve that, instead of using the windmill power that I have been using previously, we're going to try and use the water wheel here, which obviously uses water. So we need a large cogwheel and some slabs around. I do believe I have those materials already. Water wheel, bam. So from the back side here, we should be able to punch a little hole. Hopefully we get the big cog right there. We can add a shaft to it, which allows us to basically connect the rotation up. And we get our big water wheel connected to that too. So when this spins, that will go down the shaft and spin the cogs. Basically, we need to put water on one side of this and get it spinning round. I'm going to put it this side and it should flow over the top, down the side and along the bottom, creating like a sea of water for Create. Because that's the name of the mod. Aren't I thoughtful? But let's get this place a little bit less wet before we put any kind of water in. So let's put these weird windows, which are very nice. I want to put like a big grandfather clock thing behind them or something. That's what I see. Trapdoors down the bottom as well. A pane of glass just there to stop the water spinning both sides. And sploosh! We have it! We have harnessed hydraulics, apparently. How does that look from this side? Oh, the blue, wet sea of Create. And the cogs from the outside should now be spinning as well. Yes, they are. The clockwork brain is running. And what that brain has seen is this thing right here, the cart assembler. If I hold W to ponder, you will see the majesty of this. I've just had my mouth open for like the last 5 minutes non-stop. Powered cart assemblers mount attached structures to passing minecarts. Look at that! It's a block on a cart, and it doesn't stop there either, because you can then connect blocks together. And look, it puts it back off again as well. You can connect even more of them together so you can have these massive structures. And I'm just thinking of all the things I need to live, right? A bedroom, a storage room, a crafting area, a brewing area, all of these different things. I could make mini versions of them and have them go on these minecarts back and forth, dropping one off. We can basically have like a mobile base. Here is the block in question. Kind of reminds me of an airport security scanner kind of thing with a bit of a snotty, gross splodge on top. So lovely. Right, so this thing, when something goes underneath, obviously there's no block on top right now. So let's purchase some dirt, see what happens when some dirt goes across. Nothing. Oh, because we have to power the thing. Okay, so if we make this powered, it lights up. Excellent. If we bounce this cart back and forth, it brings it with it. It's so cool. And you can like stand on these as well. I don't think you can interact with them. Like I couldn't hoe this and turn it into farmland. But I can certainly stand on it, and that's good. Can I stand on it and go? I can. I feel so tall now. Okay, very nice. And then if we unpower this again and send this off on its way, it drops it back off. Okay, so this is what we want to do now. We want to get some chassis blocks. Now these things kind of stick together automatically and allow, very much like a chassis of a car would. If we put like, whoops, that's very wrong. If we put them all next to each other like this, they kind of act like slime blocks, sort of. They all stick together, so we could probably send that off on its way and it would pick up the whole thing. Oh, we need to power it. Oh, push this cart back. Should pick the whole thing up. Fantastic. Yep, that works. Brilliant. So we can then attach whatever we want to this using super glue, which is exactly more of that snotty stuff, which I think I have down here in my components chest. Super glue to the rescue. Dun dun la dun. So we should be able to splodge whatever we want on top of this. Splodge, splodge. Oh, it's got to be in like block form. Okay, so we need to do this. We need to let... Oh, I sneezed. We need to go over here, drop the thing off so that it's in block form, and then we should be able to snot on top of it. Fantastic. And then we can add whatever blocks we want. And I think we can even add them in a really big tall pillar like that. I guess we'll show it on this one, because then when you look at this thing with the... Yeah, there you go. Look, when you look at it with the wrench, it shows you it will do 8 blocks. Or I think we can go all the way up. Yeah, 16 blocks of reach this will do. Or we can bring it right back on down to just like 1 or 2 or something like that. And it will only take those blocks with it. So again, the thing is powered. And we can send this on its way, and the whole thing should move. That is incredible. Oh, it turned around as well. It was like a shark turning around with a big dirty fin. Oh, dear. The other awesome thing about this is we can literally pick up the entirety of what was on top of the minecart in a single item, so we can just move that around too, which makes, you know, doing this whole thing a lot easier. But I do have here in my hand the very first tile, and we shall see it. Blam! Oh, it's bigger than I imagined. Oh no, is it coming up through the floor? I think it might be. I can't get out of this massive hole. It's a 5x5. That's the tile size we're going for. No. It should be short enough. But I do believe if we push this button, it should deliver us our tile. It kind of did. It's backwards. Great. This was meant to be round the other way. and then if we press... the lever like that, and we push the button again, it should get taken away. Whoopsie, bad wiring. If we press it again now, it will get taken away. Just like that, and we have a fresh hole ready for the next tile. And I am going to call these things my utility tiles. Oh, and as much as I do love the sharks, look, cart movement mode, always face towards motion. I can change this pause actors while rotating. Not entirely sure what that means. But this last one, lock rotation. Hopefully now the whole thing will stay in exactly the place it needs to be. There's just information everywhere. Oh my cog. I have just discovered something unbelievably useful to this project. Take a look at these things here. These controller rails. Oh, stupid cogs. Get them out of my hand. These things are unbelievable, right? So look, if you hover over it, a unidirectional powered rail capable of fine movement control, blah, blah, blah. Basically, one direction. So it's always going to go around this way. It's always going to flow. I think I'm an idiot and these ones need to go around the other way. So I've already messed up there. But basically what these things allow you to do, it's like a powered rail. It will go on and off, except a power rail needs like a block behind it to make the cart go in one particular direction. These do not, however. So if I get myself a minecart, which I do not have, we can craft one up real quick. I've still got my enchanting table one in a contraption there. But if we just take a blank one and we pop it here, if I flick this lever on really, really quickly, this minecart's just going to do this. To the next one. To the next one. All the way to the next one. And then it's just going to keep going around. Boop, boop. To the next. It's so cool. It's so pleasing. And the best thing about it is I've got one of them underneath the cart builder as well, which also means when we power this thing on and off along with this thing on and off, just magic happens. The cart just stays there and waits. It deposits the contraption up above here so you can like interact with it and stuff like that. And then when you repower this thing, the cart goes, but it also takes the stuff with it. It's perfect. It's perfect. It's perfect. We can basically make all the carts we ever want to have down here now on all of these slots, like so. And then whenever we want to add a new utility tile, we can just quickly, literally slap them on top of an empty carts one when it goes up there. This has gone really, really well. Okay, let me show you what I have. I currently have 3 utility tiles in action, and I want you to let me know in the comments what other utility tiles we need to complete our collection. So, first up, we have our enchanting station here, and I'm going to use it to make an enchanted, hopefully, it's okay, that's just efficiency. Fine, it's better than nothing. Whatever. Next utility tile. Bam! We press the button, the next one comes up. Oh no! Oh, this is bad. Hang on a minute. This is meant to have a bed on it. Did I forget to place one? We need a bed right here. This is gonna be where I go to sleep. And we can go doink, and we can put a seat down right here with an armor stand on it. Oh no, I sat down. I sat down on the seat. If we right click, we put an armor stand on it and he actually stays riding the whole utility tile. And oh, I've got some pants. These are my magic pants to be able to put on him as well. Boom. Next utility tile. Bye bye. This one here is going to have some barrels, all the barrels in the world. And this is for all of our bulk storage. I'm just going to place a bunch of them down. We're going to put some here, some there, some everywhere. And this is where we're going to be putting all of our, like, cobblestone and all of that kind of bulk stuff, which I currently don't have too much bulk of yet because I'm trying to use absolutely everything I have. And then, bam, we push it one more time. Back comes our enchanting station. No one knew the difference. Have we got our bed back? Okay, there's a glitch. Is there no bed here? I think we have a glitched out bed. Maybe for some reason beds can't go on these because of respawn points or something. That makes me very sad. Our armor stand guy's gone too. Oh no, what happened to it? Is he down here somewhere? Maybe he fell off. I don't know. Oh, it's getting pretty clogged up down here. Oh, these things are actually, they look like blocks, but they're totally just entity tiles. You can see here, look, we've got the 3 other kind of blank utility tiles that we can add to the system. All we got to do is add more of those special track pieces along here, as long as there's like gaps between them, and then they can totally be added to the system. That's a real shame about the bed. Oh no. Oh well, you can't blame me. At least I've got a chair. Maybe I can just sit here all night. I could totally sleep sitting upright like this. That would work. And just thinking about it now, because these things, when they're in their minecarts, still actually have a hitbox, instead of having this big, old, gross, ugly hole, that to be honest, we don't see for too long, we could have another minecart just sort of sat around in entity form, clogging the hole up, just so that we don't see anything below this kind of floor level, if that makes sense. I don't know. Oh, I'm so upset that the bed's not here. That my magic pants, that honestly, I kind of lied, they weren't that magic, but the bed... Oh, that would have been great. Now I've not literally got nowhere to sleep. Oh, dear. And that is our first episode completed. I have so many ideas. I just can't get them out. But now, hopefully, we have a little bit of infrastructure going on. These mini episodes should be coming out a lot more frequently now. So thank you very, very much for watching. Don't forget, you can like, comment, subscribe. Let me know how you enjoyed this episode. Any ideas you want to send my way as well, I am more than welcoming them. So please do have those in. A massive, massive thank you to my wonderful patrons as well who help make episodes like this possible. Thank you, thank you, thank you. But until the next time, a good, a bye.